Janik, so this is a rematch, man. It's long awaited and anticipated. What can we expect, man?
Well, first fight was a great fight. It was a better fight for the fans than it was for those of us in the corner, because there was a couple of mistakes which made it real exciting and made it fight of the year. But hopefully we can correct those mistakes, bring Vic in really sharp, shoot for perfection. No fighter is going to be perfect in the ring, but we want to shoot for it. And hopefully make it as exciting, but not so close. Vic's never in a bad fight. Everybody knows that. So
you said no fighter could be perfect, but when they face each other, they were about as close as they could be there when they're prime. Since then, they both have taken a different path in their careers. During the first fight, there was a lot of speed, a lot of power, and now at this point in their careers, if you feel there has been some kind of regression from either one of them in the speed and power, who do you feel has regressed more physically in those categories?
Well, it's kind of hard to say because different fighters show up different on fight night. Perfect example is Marco Antonio Barrera. Back in the day, a lot of people said, oh, he's shot, and then he would show up and pull off one of the best performances of his career. I can say as far as my guy, I don't want to speak about Berto because I'm not in camp with him. I don't know what goes on. But as far as Vic's concerned, hasn't taken any beatings. You know, the broken jaw against Josecito, we were winning that fight. So besides that injury, you know, I think he fared pretty well. Collazo, Manny, and then Sanchez Leon, you know, they weren't very taxing on the body, so he was able to stay sharp. We're getting good sparring, so I think we're possibly going to be much fresher in this fight, and I think Vic still has a lot left to give. We'll find out on the 30th, but that's how I feel.
How do you feel about the fans always criticizing Victor Ortiz? The one thing that they like to note is that he's a quitter due to the results in the Maidana and Josito Lopez fight, but if he was a quitter, he wouldn't be here right now, right. You know, in all reality. So what's your take
and
on that?
You have to look at the we'll start with the Maidana fight. The fight was great. It was exciting. There was a lot of knockdowns. Vic was having a great fight. I think more people hold him responsible for a couple comments that he made after the fight rather than what happened in the fight. So, you know, got a concussion. You're not real sure of what you're saying. You're put on the spot. Somebody shoves a microphone in your face right after that. You know, who knows what you're going to say. And as far as the Josecito fight's concerned, I was in the corner. So I know that in the fourth round, he started complaining about jaw pain. In the fifth round, we were sure that his jaw was broken.
Yeah.
We kept pushing him a little bit, asking him for another round. Finally, he just couldn't go anymore. So I have pictures of the MRIs that they took on his jaw and everything. So it was a very severe injury. The artery was nicked. So at that point in time, it's time for the corner to say, hey, you know, that's enough. And Vic took it into his own hands just because of the situation and pulled the plug. But I don't agree with the criticism.
Yeah.
If you remember the Matisse Sorito Soto fight right before Victor fought Josecito Lopez, same card, fight before it. Sorita got dropped, got up, went back to the corner and said, hey, you know what? I'm cool. I'm not going to go anymore. Matisse hits hard. He was hurt. Never a peep, you know, about fights like that. And I don't call him a quitter.
Yeah.
It's just the way things fight. Alfredo Angulo got hit with one shot, turned his back, said, hey, you know what? That's it. You know, I got to worry about my eye. Matisse Postal, you just brought up. There's a lot of things. So if guys haven't been in the ring before and haven't faced those adversities and that kind of pain and the challenges and the sacrifices, then I don't put too much credit in what they say.